Horrid Henry Meets the Queen by Francesca Simon, read by Miranda Richardson. Horrid Henry's Chores. The weekend. The lovely, lovely weekend. Sleeping in, breakfast in his pyjamas, morning TV, afternoon TV, evening TV. No school and no Miss Battleaxe for 2 whole days. In fact, there was only one bad thing about the weekend. Henry didn't even want to think about it. Maybe Mum would forget, he thought hopefully. Maybe today would be the day she didn't burst in and ruin everything. Horrid Henry settled down in the comfy black chair and switched on his new favourite TV show, Hog House, where teenagers competed to see whose room was the most disgusting. Henry couldn't wait till he was a terrible teen too. His bedroom would surely beat anything ever seen on Hog House. Eeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeee his bed. Yuck! Shrieked Horrid Henry as Moldy Myra yanked open her cupboard. Ooh, gross! Howled Horrid Henry as Tornado Tarik showed why his family had moved out. And this week's winner for the most revolting room is... Clunk, clunk, clunk. Mum clanked in. She was dragging her favourite instruments of torture, a hoover and a duster. Peter followed. Henry, turn off that horrid programme this minute, said Mum. It's time to do your chores.
No! Screamed Horrid Henry.
Was there a more hateful, horrible word in the world than chores? Chores was worse than homework, worse than vegetables, even worse than injection, share, and bedtime. When he was king, no child would ever have to do chores. Any parent who so much as whispered the word chores would get catapulted over the battlements into the piranha-infested moat. You can start by picking up your dirty socks from the floor, said Mum. Pick up a sock? Pick up a sock? Was there no end to Mum's meanness? Who cared if he had a few old socks scattered around the place? I can't believe you're making me do this, screamed Henry. He glared at Mum. Then he glared at his crumpled socks. The socks were miles away from the sofa. He'd pick them up later. Much later. Henry, your turn to hoover the sitting room, said Mum. Peter, your turn to dust. Howled Horrid Henry. I'm allergic to hoovers. Mum ignored him. Then empty the bins and put the dirty clothes into the washing machine and make sure you separate the whites from the coloureds. Henry didn't move. It will only take 15 minutes, said Mum. It's not fair, wailed Henry. I hoovered last week. No, you didn't. I did, said Peter. I did! Screamed Henry. Liar? Liar! Can't I do it later? Said Horrid Henry. Later had such a happy way of turning into never. N-O spells no, said Mum. Peter started dusting the TV.
Stop it, said Henry. I'm watching.
I'm dusting, said Peter.
Out of my way, worm!
Hissed Horrid Henry.
Mum marched over and switched off the TV. No TV until you do your chores, Henry. Everyone has to pitch in and help in this family. Horrid Henry was outraged. Why should he help around the house? That was his lazy parents' job. Didn't he work hard enough already, heaving his heavy bones to school every day? And all the schoolwork he did. It was amazing, thought Horrid Henry, as he lay kicking and screaming on the sofa, that he was still alive. I won't! I'm not your slave! Henry, it's not fair if Mum and Dad do all the housework, said Perfect Peter. That seemed fair to Henry. Quite right, Peter, said Mum, beaming. What a lovely, thoughtful boy you are. Shut up, Peter, screamed Henry. Don't be horrid, Henry, screamed Mum. No TV and no pocket money until you do your chores, said Dad, running in. Henry stopped screaming. No pocket money? No TV? I don't need any pocket money, shrieked Henry. Fine, said Mum. Wait, what was he saying? Of course he needed pocket money. How else would he buy sweets? And he'd die if he couldn't watch TV. I'm calling the police, said Horrid Henry. They'll come and arrest you for child cruelty. Finished, sang out Perfect Peter. I've done all my chores.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.